Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And now that most of the iris and the peonies are done, it's time to cut them off, called deadheading, because that helps all of the nutrients and the energy the plant has go back into the roots rather than going to seed heads. Unless, of course, you wanted to save the seeds, and then that's a whole different story.
So how far do you take them down?
I take them down to just past the first leaf, if it's convenient for me to get there. That way the stalks are lower and it looks better. Now, granted, there's one here that could be saved, but we've had many in the house this year. And then what I have been doing this year is just cutting them into smaller pieces before I put them in the compost so that they'll compost faster.
And this is considered green.
This is green, yes.
As opposed to brown compost.
Right. So then you have to balance it out and add some dry leaves or cardboard or shredded paper in there so that you have a balance of those.
Well, I noticed you did this entire section here yesterday.
Yes, I did. I mean, it was like one day they were all standing there so beautifully, and then the next time I looked, we'd had a rain. And, you know, it had been a good 2 weeks, so I chopped them all.
And I saw you even got started on the peony bush here.
We have this one peony bush here that used to be so skinny and small, and there is a cage under there, and this year it just was magnificent and overgrown. I was counting as I was clipping, and for something like this I would count as one. I cut off 104 stems.
So far.
104 stems with multiple flowers on each. I mean, it was way down hanging on the ground. So now it just looks like a huge peony bush. But when I was talking about seeds, if you want to come and look at the peony trees, I'll tell you what I mean about saving the seed. On our peony tree, I've cut off all of the blossoms except for these three, because I want these to go to seed so that I can collect the seeds. Now, granted, this will take some of the energy away from the roots, but this is a very healthy plant, and I'm only leaving three on. I've trimmed all the other ones off, so that won't be taxing to the plant. It'll be okay.
Well, let's go over to your other peonies to see what else needs to be done yet.
Okay. Much better.
So you're still going to leave the ones that are blossoming or about to blossom up yet?
I think so. I just can't bring myself to taking them all down.
Well, you have more over on the south side.
I know.
Looks better already.
Last week this was a beautiful hedge of peonies, and now you see they're done. They're going to seed. You can see that. They're already forming the seeds. This was an extremely good year, obviously, for peonies, but I don't want them to go to seed. I want their energy to go back to the base and be a good, healthy perennial. So these all have to come off. And I'm not even going to count as I clip to amuse myself.
I'd say you only have a couple thousand. That's just on this side. Wait till you get to the west driveway.
And then I have some iris hiding in there, so those have to be clipped off too. And it'll look nicer, obviously. I mean, it was beautiful when they were flowering, but now this is the ugly stage, and then they're just gonna get brown and look ugly. So not only is deadheading good for the plant, it's good for the aesthetics of your yard. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Tell us about your garden, please, or ask questions. And do your deadheading. It's healthy for your garden. If you'd like to join our garden family, please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.
Well, should I come out and get you in about 10 hours?
About it. I couldn't figure out yesterday afternoon why I was so tired. Then
well,
I realized
why.
I've been bending over for hours, clipping.
Connect with us on YouTube.